We have two games played so far in the Champions League group stages, and we are joint top of that table with Atletico Madrid. Very, very pleased with our progress so far. This whole season has been great. And now it's time to play our next game against PSV. Looking at the top scorers, we don't have an Arsenal player there yet. I would love to do that. But yeah, there's the table. It is looking really good. And I should say as well, guys, like I just mentioned, the whole season has been incredible. So the win against Brighton in the last episode, we've obviously lost on penalties in the cup. But other than that, it's just green. A couple of draws here and there. But look at this, man. We've been absolutely killing it this season. Such an improvement from last year. And honestly, it's two things, I think. Firstly, bringing in a new goalkeeper has changed things. It really has. I feel like Martinez has come in and absolutely changed how I just don't concede as many goals. He's just so good. The other reason is I'm focusing way more. I'm trying my absolute hardest when I defend to just block those stupid passes that enable them to shoot inside the box into the top corner. And that is helping me out massively as well. Now, let's go ahead and pick our team for this game. We are going to be bringing in Pepe. We're going to take out Saka. Ødegaard is going to be dropped for Smith-Rowe. And actually, I want Lozano on the bench. We're going to give Saka a rest. He's got a little bit of missing energy there, so we'll let him get that back. And also, I'm going to start McKennie. He has been incredible recently. And I'm going to play him instead of Partey. He's not going to feature, at least not start, against his old club. Neves will play centre mid, Martinelli, Tierney, Gabriel White, Tomiyasu, Martinez. Yeah, I think this is the team I'm going to go with. En-Nesyri is now 88 rated, which is really quite something. Abraham's gone up to 83, which is good to see. Yeah, this is the team I'm going to go for. What kind of team do Atletico Madrid... Sorry, not Atletico Madrid. It's PSV, isn't it? Why is my brain going crazy today? I've been feeling weird all day today. This Friday afternoon, I've just been out of the zone. I don't know what it is. Hopefully, that's not going to affect my performances. We've got Madueke playing on that right side against us. Sangare's in there. Boshagli. Some really good players, to be fair. Some of you guys must have been so confused there when I was saying Thomas Partey isn't going to start against his old club. You're probably thinking one of two things. Either Matt is mental and thinks that he played for PSV, or Matt's just clueless and thinks it's Atletico Madrid. One of those. And it was the second one. Anyway, Tierney, captain, of course, having a really good season so far. Plays it into Neves. Straight into En-Nesyri here. On the right side for Pepe. Could this be a dream start? Chip it into the box. That's going to be a corner. We'll take that. And we will whip this one in. It's going to be Neves to take it. Oh, that's a good ball. En-Nesyri's there. No way. Out for Smith Rowe. Hits it. And it was going in. Wow. Good strike from ESR there. Cross coming in again. Pepe this time. Oh, it's not cleared. And I couldn't shoot. Even though I was pressing shoot, it wasn't letting me. Smith Rowe, please. Oh my God. PSV living dangerously at the moment. Here's Martinelli. Trying to get in there. No, that's not going to work. I just had vegetable soup for lunch. I know this is completely off topic. You're probably thinking, what the hell are you doing, Matt? I'm so hot. You know when you have soup and you just like burn internally because it's so hot? Oh my God. Oh, what a goal. Speaking of things that are hot, that finish was hot. That was terrible, Matt. But yeah, do you guys ever get that when you eat soup and then within the next half an hour, like you just feel so hot? I don't like that feeling, but it was good soup. Thanks for asking. What a start to this game though. Smith Rowe with the cross into Pepe. He volleys it. Bang. Love that. 1-0. Now Smith Rowe's in. Easy. It's too easy. Smith Rowe. 2-0. PSV are getting shredded. Their defence was nowhere to be seen there. A simple pass through. And the man that has been getting a lot more minutes this season is just justifying it. He is just justifying it. Unbelievable form. And the crazy thing is, Ødegaard is doing really well as well. So I kind of have to pick between them. I don't necessarily think I can play both of them. I probably could play Ødegaard in a deeper role. But yeah, it just goes to show the strength in this squad. The depth is really quite something. Could get him in again here. Oh my God. What a beautiful pass. Smith Rowe, why did I shoot there? And that's offside. Incredible. That's a good pass back. Madueke lays it off for Thomas. Over on this left side for Rossi. And Tomiyasu steps in just before half-time. Do we have enough time to get on the attack here? No, we're not going to. I mean, it's been a pretty good first half. I kind of fell asleep a little bit towards the end there. But they didn't punish me. It remains 2-0. It's just too easy. Look at this. Nasiri. Oh, that's a good save. I was going to say as well, every time I've used McKennie, I remember why I loved him so much in the Schalke save. He's just amazing. Oh. Oh. What more can I do there? It just gets blocked. Damn, that's unlucky. Still searching for this third goal. And PSV don't look great, if I'm being honest, guys. Every time I go forward, I look dangerous. One thing I forgot to mention that's definitely helped this season is changing to a 4-2-3-1. I really, really like it. I think I got a bit bored of the 4-3-3, but this formation just really suits me and the team I've got. Play that over on the left side. Oh my God, that's not ideal. Cross it in. Okay, again, not really ideal. McKennie should win that though. He's a tank. He's actually a tank. I'm so glad I got McKennie. I know he's not the signing I would have got if it wasn't for the objective. But honestly, I kind of wish we signed him in real life because then I could use him in FIFA. He's that good. Honestly, I love the guy. And we were linked, remember, this summer, in fact. Smith throw from our own half. Look at him go. He's not the quickest, but look, he's got enough, isn't he? Still going here. Just chip this one in for En-Nesyri. Oh my God. Too easy. Honestly, what is up with their defence? It's not the first time this season this has happened where I just seem to have one of those games where everything turns into a goal. It's so easy. Smith throw, loads of space. Just a little chipped, lobbed pass. One touch, bang. Good night. Another 3 points in the Champions League group stage. Pepe, Smith-Rowe, En-Nesyri, getting the job done. Pretty much a perfect display, other than one or two chances that they've had. But you're always going to concede some shots. You can't be perfect every time and not concede a single shot. Especially not in this FIFA, where they shoot from distance and they do get them on target. This was just a really good overall performance. And I believe last time I saw the score update, Atletico Madrid were drawing with Rapid Wien. So we could be outright leaders in the group stage. Ah, never mind. It was 4-2 in the end. It was 2-2 at half-time, I think I saw. So Atletico Madrid really turned on the style in the second half. Right, we move on to Fulham. Eighth place. They're doing better than I was expecting, actually. Let's have a look at who we've got after that. I knew it was Burnley, yep. And then it's the PSV second game. Then it's Wolves. And then it's Crystal Palace. I'd like to get all of these games done, to be honest. I might sim Fulham and Burnley. I don't think it's necessarily a bad idea to get a couple of results done a bit more quickly. Let's go ahead and put in a little bit of a changed team. I think Smith Rowe should play again. He's just playing so well. On the left, we'll go with Nelson. I'll take out Neves for Sambi. Let's go with Maitland-Niles and let's go Salisu. Why not? That is the team we're going to go with against Fulham. May I just remind you, I have not lost a game in the Premier League. I haven't lost a game in all competitions except from the Carabao Cup, and who cares about that? So I would like to remain unbeaten. And we've beaten them 3-2. Nelson getting the winner. Oh my God, and Tammy Abraham got sent off in the 38th minute. It's almost as if Tierney scored and then Abraham stripped off completely and celebrated by doing a windmill and he got sent off for it. Partey made it 2-0, but then, yeah, I mean, when you're down to 10 men for that long, Fulham are always going to score, but Nelson wins it at the end. Good job, him. And now we go ahead and we'll do the same against Burnley. Player suspended. Of course, that does mean we will not be able to use Tammy Abraham in this next game, but that's all right. Maybe we'll go with Nketiah for this one. Why not? They're playing a 4-4-2. I don't really want to use En-Nesyri when I've got Champions League in 2-3 games. So yeah, I'm going to go with Nketiah. I'll go with Ødegaard, Pepe, and I'll go with, instead of Partey, I'm going to go McKennie, who's only two ratings below him, which is pretty crazy. For this one, I'll take out White for Saliba, and I'll also go with Tavares. So it is considerably weaker, but it should be okay. We'll quick sim against Burnley, auto-replace the red-carded player that isn't available, and it's another 3-2 win. En-Nesyri hat-trick? No. Saka scored, but then En-Nesyri got a double to win it. We were 2-1 down, and then En-Nesyri came on and did some serious damage. Wait, hang on. En-Nesyri didn't get subbed on. What? Can someone explain that? I had Nketiah up front. Unless I'm going mad, when I go back to edit this, I'll have to check. That was weird. I'm pretty sure I put Nketiah up front instead of En-Nesyri. Oh well, who cares? We won the game, and now we're back in the Champions League against PSV again. We've got some emails, progress assessment. Okay. Tammy Abraham is back. Player suspended. Yep, we've already had that. So, he will be fit to play this if I want him to, Abraham. Yeah. 83 rated already. He is doing well, isn't he? But I'm quite happy with this team up against PSV. I think if we win this, we're going to be looking very good to go through along with Atletico Madrid. The two favourites looking like they're pretty unstoppable at the moment. Draws, I guess, you kind of can claim as stopping someone, but you know what I mean. Rapid VN haven't gained a single point yet. Let's do this press conference. It's always good to get some team morale. And because I've got quite a big squad, keeping everyone happy is quite difficult. So I should be doing these. Can you turn PSV over again? The lads can't wait. Let's do it again. Absolutely. Will you try anything different? We'll look at what worked, I guess. But nothing didn't work, so shouldn't be too much of a problem. Can you keep this great run going? I think there's more to come. Yes, there's the morale boost I was looking for. The game wants me to play in my home kit against their home kit. Yeah, that's not going to work. They can go in their away kit. Wait, hang on. Have they added third kits in the latest updates? My God, it is one of the worst kits. Not just PSV's one, but all of the Puma third kits, the alternate kits, they're absolutely disgusting. You've got to have a badge. I'm sorry, but it just looks so wrong without it. I want to see it in game. I'm going to leave it on that one. The lineup I've gone with is very different. I'm trying a 4-4-2 because just why not? I want to try things out. It does mean we've got two strikers, Abraham and En-Nesyri up top. I thought about going with Nketiah. I could still do that. Actually, should I maybe go with one big, one small, if that makes sense? Maybe having both En-Nesyri and Abraham's a bit overkill. So, yeah, I'm actually going to do that. We'll take En-Nesyri off and let's take out Neves. We'll give him a break. So, Abraham and Nketiah, Partey, Sambi, Lozano's going to feature on that left side, Saka on the right. Maitland-Niles will start at right back. Or should I give Dest a go? I haven't used Dest enough. I want to try him again. Saliba, Salisu, Tierney and Martinez in goal. As I said before, I think a win here should set us up nicely to qualify for the round of 16. And of course, that would equal my progress from last season where I got to the round of 16 and then got bullied by PSG. I'm not letting that happen this season, okay? First of all, I'm not going to get drawn with one of the top teams. It's not going to happen, okay? I trust the game will be nice to me this time and give me an easier game. That's what I'm hoping for, an easier tie. And also, I think I am better. I'm getting better at the game the more I play. And this is an unbelievable start. Oh, no. Oh, no. Oh, he got there. I thought I overran it. The keeper was slow, but Lozano was rapid to catch up with that heavy touch. He squares it to Nketiah, and it is 1-0 already. This great form just continues. Yeah, Madueke is interesting. Very difficult to get the ball from him. Oh, Martinez. What a save that is. But I noticed this in the last time we played them, in the last game. Every time Madueke got the ball, he did something. He got a cross in or whatever. He's really quite good. So if I can keep them away from that right side, let them play down the left, I think we'll be absolutely fine. Oh, no. Oh, it's off the bar. Jeez. Well, that was a little bit close, wasn't it? Not sure about the 4-4-2, actually. It might be really good when you play against it, or at least when I play against it, it seems to be doing really well. But, yeah, I'm not sure it's working very well. Could be the players I'm using with the formation. I don't know. I'm going to keep at it. Keep trying. Trying to get Lozano in behind here. 33 minutes played already. Chasing the keeper here, putting the pressure on. Should be able to win that with Partey. What was that? He took so long to charge up for that jump. He just took his sweet time, didn't he? He was having a cup of tea and a biscuit before he decided to actually run and challenge for it. Okay, Dest is so good. Oh my God, what a ball as well. Keeper's come out. Tammy Abraham took an age to get there as well. He's so lanky. I love Tammy, though. I've really enjoyed using him so far this season. We've got the ball back. Here's Sambi. Inside to Nketi. He's onside, but can't finish it. Unlucky. Let's see if we can do something from the corner, though, right before the break. Again, it's gone back to Thomas Partey taking the corners. I keep taking him off them in the main menu, and he's just scorpion kicked the pass. Sambi. Oh, it's another goal for Sambi. He has been scoring a lot of nice goals this season. He's had a volley, and now he's got one outside the box with his weaker left foot. And that pass from Thomas Partey is just more hilarious every time I see it. What a strike. Sambi, take a bow. Right before halftime as well. 2-0 up. We're looking good for yet another win. I'm enjoying this. Look, you might not be as much because, oh, it might be boring seeing him win and win and win. But for me, right now, this is the best run I've been on in this series. I just desperately need it. I really do. There will be a time this season when results start to drop. My morale and my enjoyment of the game will drop and I will struggle. It's inevitable. It will happen. But right now, in these first few months of season three, I am loving every second of this. It's genuinely a breath of fresh air to actually feel like I can win games and kind of control them myself. Oh my God. The CPU are so aggressive since the latest patch. That could be a red card. Oh, it's not even a yellow. Incredible. Okay, we've got a really good opportunity to smash one in here. But I don't have my best free kick takers. Neves would have been great here. But Partey smashes it. It's off the bar. Rebound for Lozano. Yeah, he's not going to win that header. Oh, yeah, okay. Okay. I've conceded a stupid goal here. What just happened, man? You've just got to laugh. It's a good delivery in, but, I mean, nothing special. Is that a Dest own goal, or has it actually come off the number 17 there? It's a Dest own goal, I'm pretty sure. Oh, dear. There it is. That's a shame. He's been really good in this game. It's not his fault. That's just the game being a little bit silly. It just clearly couldn't get the ball out of his feet. 2-1. Oh, here we go. Nketiah. It's a race. And he's lost out. What was that first touch? Absolutely ruined it. Win it, Partey. There you go. Tammy flicks it onto Saka. Give it to Partey again. Oh, that pass from Tammy was too heavy. All of a sudden, I'm struggling. Have I jinxed it? Have I actually jinxed myself by saying, it's great fun having control of games and actually winning? Okay, just ignore it. Ball over the top now. Partey could be in. Baumgartel, good header. 20 minutes to go. Time to make a change. I think I'm going to switch formation and go to the 4-1-2-1. Not the 4-1-2-1-2. The 4-2-3-1. I'm going to take Abraham out and bring in Ødegaard. Saka, just make sure I convert the wingers to their actual positions so they get the plus rating. I'm actually going to take Lozano out and bring in Martinelli. Why hasn't he got the plus 5 or whatever? Has he not got... What? It makes no sense. He's happy. His sharpness is good. He's very happy, sorry. His fitness and sharpness are fine. Why isn't he getting a plus rating? Hang on, let me refresh it. Oh, there we go. So it's just a visual bug. No surprise. Lokonga out for McKennie. And convert him to centre mid. and Dest out for Tomiyasu. Oh my God, I can't count. I'd already made three subs. Matt, come on. I actually got a very good result in my maths exams, okay? An A in my GCSEs. I will not have any comments saying you're bad at maths, okay? I did very well in my GCSEs in general. I'm not stupid. I just am a bit, you know, at times. It makes me feel so old talking about GCSEs. Like, a lot of you guys watching this video are probably going through early stages of secondary school, late stages of secondary school, maybe college, your first few jobs, whatever. I'm 28 in February next year. I mean, no, I'm 29. Oh my God, I am stupid. I can't even remember how old I am. I'm 29 in February. It's just frightening. I can barely even remember what happened 10 years ago now. And I was 19-ish. It's just mental. Honestly, I know old people say it all the time, your parents, whatever. Oh, time goes so fast. Your life is going to flash before you. It goes so quickly. For once in my life, in the last few years, it's actually happening. It is coming true. I always used to laugh and say, yeah, yeah, whatever. But no, the last 10 years have literally gone like that. Just 12 years on YouTube feels like five. It's unreal, guys. Enjoy life as you are right now. If you're healthy, happy, enjoy that, because a lot of people would kill for it. A lot of people would love to be younger. A lot of people would like to be healthy if they're sick or whatever. Just, I don't know where this is going. Just enjoy and be grateful for what you've got. It's Christmas soon as well. Spend some time with your family. The last few years have been absolutely horrendous for everyone. And I hope everyone's all right, man. I do. I don't want to seem like I'm, what's the word? I don't even know what the word is. I'm just spitting facts. Oh my God, we almost lost. I mean, almost drew. That was close. Okay, 2-1 win. More green, more W's on the calendar. Love that. Bruno Fernandes, player of the month now. It was Iheanacho before. Now it's Bruno Fernandes. Are we going to have a player of the month? That'd be nice at some point. Unfortunately, Smith Rowe has now finished his growth for this year. But 82 rated, 23 years old, there's still plenty more to come from him. Just maybe not this season. We've got some players out on international duty coming up soon. But first, a game against Wolves. They are sixth in the table. So this should be a winnable game, but it will be a tough one away at the Molyneux. We are top of the table by 3 points, but we are 9 points clear of Leicester, 10 points clear of Aston Villa. We are really doing well. Ruben Neves, up against his old club, of course. What a signing he's been. Really, really quite some player. A bit of everything in midfield. Of course he was going to start today. He's next to Sambi. I've dropped Partey for this one. Got Smith Rowe on the left with Ødegaard in the middle. So no Martinelli. Just, again, switching players around. You know, I don't want to be using the same players all the time. And while I'm playing so well and getting good results, it's a good chance to try some other things out that maybe I normally wouldn't. But I did notice they've got David up top, the Canadian striker that plays for Lille, I think it is. I had some pretty fair criticism at the start of this series when I signed, not series, this season, when I signed Tammy Abraham and then went on to sign the three North American players. A lot of people said I probably should have got David. There he is on the ball. And, oh God, that could have deflected and gone anywhere. It's a very fair criticism. I just didn't think of it. Jonathan David was linked with Arsenal, as everyone is linked with Arsenal these days. But it looked quite genuine, and I could have signed him, and it would have been, oh my God, that was close. It would have been 1 out of 3, and I wouldn't have needed to sign Tammy. But hey, it is what it is. I am human. I make mistakes. I just didn't think of it at the time. It's been a good start from Wolves, this. Cody, is he going to shoot? Go on then, Cody, have a shot. Not you, David. I don't want you shooting. Or you, Neto. Jeez, we can't even get out of the box at the moment. It's going to be another corner to come in. I'm going to make sure I defend this one and actually just get it out. Oh, God. Was that Cody again? It was. He almost scored in that top corner. Another corner coming in. And this time, there we go. Oh, my God. What a clearance to Saka up against Semedo. That is a race I'd want to watch. And it is close. What do we do here? I think we have to cross it. Oh, And Nasiri, no! And it's fallen in a great position for Smith Rowe, but he just wasn't in the right place. Saka over to Smith Rowe. The two Hale End players combining well. And it's back into the box. And Nasiri, what a save from that header. Oh, wow. Very, very good game so far for you guys watching. End-to-end stuff. Over the top for Ødegaard. Is he going to get there? No! It was so close. I'm surprised he was onside, actually. It didn't look it at first. Oh, no. No, 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 no. I've got a player down. I think it's Sambi, which wouldn't be the worst player to lose. Oh, and now we're 1-0 down. Kick the ball out. Why aren't they kicking the ball out? There's an injury. That's what the Arsenal fans would be saying, in real life at least. It doesn't happen in FIFA unless the player is actually injured to the point where he needs to come off. The ball will stay in play and they will carry on. Yeah, not a good way to concede when you've got a player down, and especially a key player like Sambi playing in midfield. He is injured properly, isn't he? Yeah. He's holding his shoulder, I think it was. I just saw him doing his holding his right shoulder. Hopefully it's nothing serious because he's been in really good form. But I'm going to try and get to half-time, see if he can run the injury off as we get Nasiri in here. Trying to get it onto his left. Still going. Oh my God. Take a bow, you Moroccan beauty. That is disgusting. Oh my God. I am forever impressed with Nasiri's ability to do everything. He's just an all-rounder. What a finish this is. Off the bar and in. Oh, 1-1. Perfect time to score as well. Right after we concede. Sambi, where are you? I'm trying to select you. He's still got the injury. Oh, man. That really is annoying because he's been great. Really enjoyed using him. I wanted to use him ahead of Partey for this game. And he's picked up an injury. Hopefully, like I said, it's nothing serious. Can we get another goal before halftime? Look at Saka. Please, Saka, take it. Yes, he's got it. Finish it. Oh, what a save. We will get the corner in. Do I take Sambi Lokonga off? Yeah, I think I do. I'm going to take McKenny and put him in that position. Straight swap. Saka gets the ball in. Nasiri was there. Out for Smith Rowe. Bang! Oh! And it hits the back black posts. Whatever you want to call those. The net supports. Net supports. The beams. The poles. The net poles. The rods. I don't know. Anyway, that is going to be half time. What a game this has been. He's in again. Jeez. So much power behind the shot. Hey! He just knocked over Ødegaard and pretty much stamped on his face. Come on, ref. Are you blind? Here is Saka. Nasiri. On his left foot. I just tried to hit one from there, but Tomori stepped in. Shut me down. No, you will not shoot from there. And now they're on the break. Gabriel to slide in. Oh my God, you just got crunched. We call that the Brazilian crunch. There you go. Oh, and then Bolly. Yeah, he just steps in and takes it. What would be a better name? A Brazilian beatdown? A Brazilian battering? I don't know. Oh, Nasiri was in there. If that ball gets in behind, it's 2-1. 100%. And now Wolves are going to get on the attack. Can't intercept the past. The past? Can't intercept the pass is what I'm trying to say. I'm in a really weird mood today. I don't know if you can tell. Less than 5 minutes to go here. Maitland-Niles has come on into midfield. Go on, Pepe. He's also come on the left side. Here we go. The winner in 3, 2, 1, no. That would have been cool, though, if I got to one and it landed on Nasiri's head and he just slammed it in. Here we go. Corner. Nasiri's there. Oh, comes out for Maitland-Niles to Ødegaard. Can he win it? Oh, this keeper, José Sá. Unreal performance from him. I'm going to play it short, I think. Give that to Ødegaard. And then just chip it delicately. Oh, it almost worked out for us. One last chance here. And I've just given it away. Damn, this was a tough one. Wolves were really difficult to break down. Five at the back, insane goalkeeper performance. And maybe I wasn't playing at my best, but we take a draw. It's not that bad at all. We're still unbeaten in the league. That gold trophy, we're going to win it for the second time, right? No, that's impossible. So let's find out the bad news. Player injured. 5 days. It's just a bruised shoulder. Poor Sambi. You're going to be okay, mate. He will be fit for not the next game. Oh, actually, no. There's an international break. So he's fine. He's back and ready to go against Crystal Palace, I guess. Let's just double check. And there he is. He's absolutely fine. I don't know what's happened to Sambi. He's just been brilliant lately. 88 short passing, 88 stamina, which is really good. 80 agility. Yeah, he's just a superb all-rounder. But it is funny, if you compare him with McKenny, for example, who's just 3 ratings higher, look at the difference. Sometimes, though, it isn't about the stats. It's how the player plays, you know, and you get a feel, don't you? Whoa, Ødegaard is 90. He's almost finished with his development plan, so he's going to be a cam again soon. He is 90 rated. Our first 90 rated player. Tierney, 88. En-Nesyri, 88. Unreal, man. Absolutely unreal. So what we're going to do to end this episode is play the game against Palace. Well, actually, no, we're going to sim. That's what I mean. We're going to use the match sim. And then in the next episode, we kick off with a huge one against Atletico Madrid. So that means we do need to change up the squad completely. So Abraham comes in. Smith Rowe at cam. We'll go with Lozano. Or do I go Nelson? Or do I go Martinelli? Ooh, I've got choices to make here. I'm going to go Nelson. It's the right thing to do. I'm going to go Pepe on that side. Neves out for Lokonga. I'm going to keep Partey in there. Tomiyasu, we'll swap out for Maitland-Niles. And then we'll go with the Sally brothers, of course. And then we'll go with Tavares. And why not give Ramsdale a go as well? So that's the lineup here against Crystal Palace, who have a strong team. Quick sim. Are we still unbeaten? No. We've lost our first game of the season, and it's to Crystal Palace. Unbelievable. We had the same amount of shots and chances as them. We had more possession, but I mean, sometimes it happens. To be fair, I'm kind of glad the unbeaten run's over because the pressure's now going to be off a little bit. I don't have to try and continue that stupid run we're on, but unfortunately, the calendar has a second L. Oh, what a shame. In the next episode, Atletico Madrid, City, Leeds, and then we go into a crazy December, so many games. And before you know it, as I've said recently, we will be into the latter stages of the Champions League when it gets real tasty. So thank you for watching all the episodes this week. Hopefully you're enjoying the Facebook videos as well. Don't forget, 7 p.m. every weekday is YouTube content, and then 9 p.m. every single weekday is Facebook content. And then on the weekends, if Arsenal play, there's an Operation Arsenal. So that's my content schedule at the moment. I'd really appreciate it if you could subscribe and follow me on all of my accounts. I will see you next Monday for a brand new episode and our second game against Atletico Madrid.